All right, back to city government, and I believe this is pretty much all over the United States, this particular discussion. It's about the city busing of children, young adults, into schools, public schools in other areas. Now, I kind of want to immediately change that system. I believe we need to go back to something where it is more of an exchange student program, very similar to what they have in Europe. You know, you're a traveling exchange student, deemed upon your grades, deemed upon your particular skills. And so instead of moving, busing children, you know, miles and miles and miles away, any child, we only take the children that are needing some kind of additional education for their advancement, because they are already achievers. They're already high achievers. And so because they're already high achievers, they are getting a new input. Okay, you cannot give this to the low achievers, because the low achievers just drag their low achiever around, all right? That becomes just a messy slop across the United States. I really want to cancel the whole importing children back and forth to this area, to that area. So we need to leave the children in their own area, the young adults, the teenagers, and only give it to the ones who have accoladed to accreditations, who have very high grades, who are scholastic examples, who are absolute examples of their former school. So when they're an example of the former school, the height of that school, you know, the baccalaureate of that school, that is a proud exchange. You understand? So we have the proudest of the proudest. And that is a different build, rather than just get them out of here. We have too many. So yeah, I guess so. I guess I'm not popular with this opinion by many, because you think, well, no, it's better for the children to go to another area, you know. Maybe the area they are born and raised in is dangerous. Well, unfortunately, this is a rise above a society. If you do not rise above, you have to keep living in where you are dangerous, in that dangerous society, you know what I mean? You do not get the privilege. You should not be given the privilege. It's costing way too much money. I already see it. I already know it's costing way too much money. Each bus. I mean, what are you people? You know, you're just non-stop. You own an oil company. I mean, it's just the public school system. I mean, it should only be for 10 children, 10 teenagers from each high school to be exchanged. That's all. And if it is a bad neighborhood, if it is a bad school, and there would be a reason for 10 to go there. Do you understand? There would be a reason. Because those ones, those privileged learned ones, would want to go there. Because there is something they want to study from that group. You understand? There's something they want to study from that group. That inner city school. So this is not a damnation. It's not a damnation. To have to go into the inner city school to be that 10 exchange student. That 10 exchange student will be very excited, because perhaps that's what they're learning for in school. Maybe they want to be lawyers. They want to be in law. Do you understand? They want to study human relationships. They want to study aggressions. They want to be some kind of behavior analyst. So when all of this is going on, that is a tremendous excitement for those achieved children to get in there and be the smartos. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's about, what a dredge down. you know, the parents move here or the parents move over there for a reason. You know, these are their children. They want them raised in that particular environment. They want them to go to that school. And they end up, what? They end up going to school with the students that are bussed in from probably 30 miles away. I cannot even believe what's going on here. It's just ridiculous. It's just excessive use of a public school system. So that has to stop. We just have to stop that. I don't know. That's my input on the thing, whatever. All right?